From inside Tropicana Field here in Tampa Bay, MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. First pitch coming your way next.
Defending American League East champion, Tampa Bay Rays.
So just about set, Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. Next offering in the dirt, two balls, two strikes.
All these guys were shut out in the previous game, and I'm really interested to see what did they talk about in that hitters meeting that's going to translate into the game and help them be able to get on the scoreboard.
So digging in, Aaron Judge. Good contact guy, good defender. Margot on his way over. One down, base is empty. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Joey Gallo steps to the plate. The next pitch misses, and the count's full. Left-hand batter waits. Hit on the ground, might be two. To Franco for one. Back to first, double play. And that's it for the inning. Bottom of the first, and stepping in for the Rays, Brandon Lau. Here's a 1-1.
The count is 2-1.
That one fouled off. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and one out now. Here's Wander Franco, a switch hitter batting right. The wide to kick the pitch. Popped in the air, left field. Hauls it in, two away.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Next pitch is in the dirt. 2-1.
2-1 the count now. He hasn't seen a fastball yet, but you've got to be ready to hit one because you doubt the pitcher wants this to go to a 3-1 count.
Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And the inning is over. New inning getting started. Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now. Fouls one off, 2-2. And the pitch. Swing and a ball popped up. Lau pulls it down, and there's one down. Now it's Josh Donaldson's turn to hit. No score here in the second. Stays alive. And a base hit on a line. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single. Here is the young phenom, Gleyber Torres. The 3-1. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
So here we go again with the walks. It's been a real struggle finding the zone for him in the past. Now, even if they get out of this jam, these walks add pressure and stress to the entire team.
In the air, left field, a Rosarena under it. Snags it for the second out. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate.
The shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
The 1-1. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The pitch. That one ripped. Up against the wall and brings it in. Bottom of the inning. Now here's the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Randy Arozarena. And a pitch. Here's a high chopper. And he can't come up with it. He decides to eat it, and they catch a break as they get a base runner at first. And now the hitter, G-Man Choi.
G-Man Choi.
The pitch. In there at the knees, and now 2-2. Montgomery picks over. Oh, the throw is wild. Arozarena on at first. Nobody out. The next offering misses, and the count is filled up.
So here we go. Base runner at first. Could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate. Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
Yandy Diaz now. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And down on strikes. And there's one away. Manuel Margot up to the plate. Grounder might be two. Off balance speed, there's one. Over to first, safe. Here's Mike Zunino. Big time power.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Smoked on the ground a second. Torres fires over to first. And Zunino is set down. And the inning is over. Here at Tropicana Field, all set for the start of the inning. Now at the plate, Ben Wortvedt. Next pitch misses, and that's ball two. And here it comes.
Ball,
that's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Pitch popped up. Franco under it, and it's caught for the out. Back to the top of the lineup, and here is Anthony Rizzo. Top of the third, no score. Popped up. Diaz should have this one. Puts it away for the out. Two outs, base is empty. Aaron Judge now at the plate. At the belt and fires. That one misses. It's 2-2. Swing and a miss. Curveball in the dirt. In time, the 2-3 strikeout ends the inning. Back here at the ballpark as we go to the last of the third. Now up for Tampa Bay, Kevin Kiermaier. Ball and a strike.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
There's a line drive to left field. Can't get there, base hit.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate.
Rudder takes off. Pitch misses. Throw to second. Great jump, and that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close. Here's a 2-1. Up the middle. The tag, and he's out. And the batter will be the shortstop, Wander Franco. 0 for 1 so far. Here's a 1-1. Good eye right there. No score here, but a runner at third with one down. Next one misses, and now 3-1.
I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
And the 3-1. And that one hit to first. But it's 1-0 as the run scores. Austin Meadows now.
This guy's seen two changeups in a row. Could be a little vulnerable for a fastball right here.
Next offering is down low, and the count is 2-2. The pitch. And there's a fly ball deep right field, and it's out of here. Austin Meadows powers one out of here, and they tack on to their lead. It's 2-0. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Reached on an infield single his first time. And that one lifted in the air center field. Hicks makes the grab, and that is the inning. And welcome back. Start of the fourth, and stepping in for the Yankees, Joey Gallo.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And it's through for a hit. So a man on base to start the inning. And here is Giancarlo Stanton. That drilled him. That's the first out in the top of the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Gallo, the runner at second with one away. Ripped into right field, base hit. They won't risk the send. Runners at the corners now with one away. So one out with two aboard. Here is Gleyber Torres. 1-1 now. On the ground. Throw over to Choi. Now two away as they get a run across. Aaron Hicks at the plate. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time. Next pitch inside, and a count 2-1. Runner leads away at second. Swing and a miss, and the count's even at 2.
Well, you got to find a way to catch up to that pitch. Perhaps shorten the swing, eliminate the stride. That one came in hot, but right down the middle, you're saying to yourself, how did I miss that pitch? Got to make a quick adjustment.
He's got it, and that is out number 3. Bottom four, and stepping in for the Rays, G-Man Choi. Here's a 1-2. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. And now the lefty. And that skips in the dirt. The punch out there, and that's the first out. Here's the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. The wind of the pitch stays alive. Got him looking. Two out. Here's Manuel Margot. He's 0 for 1. Ripped to third and caught. Back now in Tampa Bay. And now the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Here comes a pitch. And there's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Ben Wortvedt stepping in now for the Yankees. He's 0 for 1. Next offering is in for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Line drive, that's a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Well, that at bat had a lot of pressure riding on it, so really great job coming through right there. It's got to feel good. That ball was drilled 106 off the bat, and that's the kind of feedback that tells you you're...
Dives, but it kicks off his glove. And he beats it. That's a hit. Great try there. Here comes Aaron Judge. All loaded up. Dangerous hitter at the plate. Kiner-Falefa, the runner at third. Wortvedt on second. Rizzo at first with no outs. Now this one's well hit. Way back there. On its way and out of here. Grand slam. Aaron Judge leaves the yard, and it gives them the lead in the fifth. It's 5-2. So they turn to the lefty in this spot, Josh Fleming. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And now it's Joey Gallo. Kicks and fires. And now two balls and a strike.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Swing and a miss. And the count is even, 2-2. Up the middle. And they take care of Gallo for the out. Giancarlo Stanton at the plate. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Next offering is downstairs. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Next pitch in for a strike, 2-2. Kicks and deals. On the ground to short, Franco handles. Fires over to first. And they take care of Stanton for the out. Here's Josh Donaldson. The wind and the pitch. And a count 1-2. And a foul ball. The wind and the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
Stays alive. 1-2 now. That one to first. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. That's out number three. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And here's the catcher, Mike Zunino. Here's a 1-1. Hit in the air, right field. Judge is under it, and there's one down. Kevin Kiermaier next to hit for the Rays. 1-for-1 with a single and a run scored so far.
Kiermaier.
And a pitch. And there's a ball.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
The next offering misses, and the count is 3-1. Left-hand hitter waits. Swung on, belted. That one's deep. Pulls it in on the warning track. And now it's Brandon Lau. He provides a surprising amount of pop from the second base position.
Listen, that's not something to take lightly. Getting that kind of production from the guys up the middle, it's not a strength of most lineups. Boo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. On the ground, out to short. Gets it to first. Franco gone on the play. And that'll do it. Top of the sixth inning. And stepping in for the Yankees, Gleyber Torres. Foul ball, he stays alive.
Well, that ball was hit pretty hard and sure had home run distance, but if you're the pitcher out there on the mound, you execute it. Just a long strike, you go after him and finish him off.
Next pitch is popped up. Makes the grab, and there's one down. Here's Aaron Hicks. This has always been the better side for Aaron Hicks. Swing and a miss, 3-2 now.
You tie a guy up like that, you're feeling like you are in command.
The wide to kick the pitch. Lifted in the air, right field. Margot under it. Puts the squeeze on that one. And there's two away. Two outs, bases empty. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa getting ready to hit. 3-2 now. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The pitch. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. And he deals. Now this is in the air down the line. A Rosarena has this one sized up. Makes the catch, inning over. There we go, bottom six. Now it's the DH, Austin Meadows. Swings and misses. That is strike two. And the pitch. Right side, collected by Torres. Leadoff man retired in the sixth. So up next, Randy Arozarena. 1-for-2. And that one hammered. And it bangs off the top of the wall. The throw into second. In there safely.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity. Right on top of it.
Now it's going to be G-Man Choi. Up the middle. Kiner-Falefa throws to first in time. Two away. So two down now. And here is Yandy Diaz. Who's 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts. The 1-1. And that one missing low. And the pitch. Next offering misses down and away. And a pitch. This one in the air right field. Judge cutting across. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Welcome back. We go to the top of the seventh. Here's the Yankees catcher now, Ben Wortvedt. Next offering is in for a strike. Left-hand batter waits. Gets under and pops it up. One up, one down. Anthony Rizzo stepping in now for the Yankees. The 1-1. Yeah, there's the strike.
Oh, and you can throw that big curve on the inside part of the plate. Very difficult pitch for the hitter to get on plane with. You can have a lot of success if you can pitch in that location.
The 2-2. And there's a foul ball. And here it comes. And that one is lifted in the air. A Rosarena makes the grab. And there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. And now big number 99, Aaron Judge, for the fourth time tonight. Here's a 2-2. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Judge out on the play. And that is the third out of the inning. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Clay Holmes. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now it's the right fielder, Manuel Margot. Next pitch is outside. Right-hander kicks, deals. And fouled off. Righty to the plate. And Margot able to spoil that one. Comes a 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One gone here. Now here is Mike Zunino. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. Right-handed reliever. That misses the zone. Ball two. And the right-hander deals. Stays alive. And the righty deals. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Two down. Here's Kevin Kiermaier. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Fought off foul. Righty delivers. That one ripped right center field, way back there. And it's gone. Home run. He'll touch them all. And they slice into the lead. It's 5-3. Chad Green ready to go. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Number 57.
So the batting order turns over. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Brandon Lau. The pitch.
Well, that's okay.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Well, you know this guy wants to swing it, but he's showing some good patience in this one. It's the second time he's taken ball four.
Now batting Wander Franco. The 1-1. Just missed.
The count is 2-1.
The tying run at the plate. Gallo towards the line. Flashes the leather on the running catch. And that is that. Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Brooks Raley. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Back here at the ballpark, and now, Joey Gallo. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
Well, we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slog is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
And he chases that one. One away. And now it's Giancarlo Stanton. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. At the belt and fires. Cut on and miss, struck him out, and there's two down. Now the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. Next offering upstairs.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal, because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, he can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
The 1-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that is that. New arm out of the bullpen, Jonathan Loaisiga. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Back here at Tropicana Field, now it's Austin Meadows. And a 1-1 in the air, center field. Gallo giving chase. Nice grab on the run, and there's one away.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
To the right side, the throw to first. And a couple of quick outs. G-Man Choi digs in now.
The first baseman, G-Man Choi.
Two outs. And a big swing and a miss.
Looking very settled on the mound here in the eighth. One more out, and they'll probably hand it off to their closer for the ninth with at least a two-run lead.
The next pitch misses, and it's 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. Here comes a pitch. Swing, and this one's bounced on the ground. And he picks it up, and he'll put it in his pocket. And a payoff pitch. And that's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Kicks and fires. He swings and fouls one off. Tying run at the plate. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Jeffrey Springs on the pitch here, and he'll do his best to keep this close. Now in Tampa Bay, we go to the ninth, and stepping in for the Yankees, Aaron Hicks. The wind of the pitch. Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. An absolute blast to left, and they add a run. It's 6-3. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa will hit next. Next pitch inside, and it's 2-1.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Next pitch is popped up. Lau. No play. That's an infield single. Ben Wortvedt stepping in now for the Yankees. Kiner-Falefa aboard here at first with nobody out. Next pitch misses, and now 3-2. Bounced up the middle into the outfield, base hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out. So the lineup flips over. Anthony Rizzo now at the plate. The 1-1. That one hit the knees for a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
Good eye right there.
The real threats are coming up. Already given up a home run in this inning. It's going to really have to bear down.
Next offering way off the plate. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
You know, Boog, it's been said these guys are savages in the box. You can see it right there with such tight plate discipline.
Here's a 1-2. And another ball.
Good slider down and in can be so hard to get on plane with. You're better off taking that pitch.
And that's going to be a double, and it'll score two. One run across. Another scores. Two runs in on the play, and it's 8-3.
Picks himself up a couple of ribbies. Pretty much just a textbook double into the gap. And when you can drop one in there between the outfielders, you know you're making the turn at first. Just an excellent win.
They hand the ball over to a new arm, Matt Whistler. And we'll see how he performs in this situation with his team down big. Here's Joey Gallo. The pitch. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. And a pitch. Right through there, got him. And that's the first out. Now here's Giancarlo Stanton.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
The pitch. Swing and a miss, and the count is 1-2.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Got him. Out number two. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. Here's a 1-1. And that's downstairs and outside. The pitch. There's a strike. And he deals. That misses off the outside edge.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike.
Base hit. One run is in. The tag, and that's out number three. Inning over. Last chance for the home team. And now the right fielder, Manuel Margot. And a 3-1 on the way. Swings through that one for strike two. Three and two now. This one popped up, middle of the infield. Puts it away for the out.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
And he walked him. Here's Kiermaier now. Singing, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Left-hand hitter waits. Swings through that one. So how much does his speed factor into his ability to go get it?
It's heartbreaking for the hitter because off the bat, he thinks this ball's going to get down. Because of that speed and the ability to make up so much ground, he enters the picture and breaks a guy's heart.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. The pitch stays alive. And a pitch. Swings and misses. And there are two down. Lucas Litke comes on now. And he'll try to keep this big lead right where it is. So the Rays batting order turns over. Lau at the plate. Zunino off of first with two away. Into left center for a line drive base hit. Here comes Zunino around third. Throw cut off, out of the plate. And he's in there. A run comes in on the play.
Well done. Drives in the run. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
At the plate, Wander Franco. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Gallo settles under this one. He's got it. Ball game. The Yankees slug their way to a win in this one.
Winning never gets old, but it's also important to come out and play with some level of a fear of failure. That's what brings out the best, knowing that if I don't bring it today, we could lose. And nobody likes to lose, especially when you work this hard to play at this level. Nice win today.
Four, our final score. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
final line score tonight. First for the victorious Yankees, 9 runs, 11.